Hey, what's up guys? Today we are back with our silicone brain molds, and today is the day we're making gummy brains. Now remember in our last project we took silicone and poured it over real cow's brains, then we ripped the molds open, removed the brains, and then sterilized our molds in a solution of bleach and dish soap for 12 hours. Today our molds are clean, ready for use, and here's what they look like now. Now you might be wondering how these molds smell after having cow brains, and I'm actually kind of wondering the same thing. Pleasantly enough, they smell like bleach. They smell very, very clean. And I've actually run a couple of batches of water through these and turned them into ice. That would have extracted anything that might have leached into the silicone as well. So these should be safe and ready for casting. At least they're safe enough for my purposes. I also pre-made a batch of purple and green gummies, so all we have to do now is throw these things in the microwave to remelt them, pour them in the molds together so we can make some kind of a purplish-green gummy zombie brain. At least that's the idea. And we wait. All right, green is good, purple's next. We're gonna throw that on for about 2 minutes. Oh yeah, purple is nice and molten. There's still a little bit of a chunk there in the center, but there's enough heat in the rest of the liquid that it should completely melt that. So let's just let that sit out for a couple minutes and work on preparing our molds. If you look closely here, I think while these were soaking in the bleach, it actually kind of discolored the silicone a little bit. We got little purple tendencies around the edges of our mold. But that shouldn't affect the way our molds turn out. Now because these molds are so thick, they pretty much hold themselves together. And if you look closely, when you push them together, all the cracks and seams seem to line up perfectly. They almost virtually disappear, and that's a good thing. I'm just gonna use a little bit of electrical tape around the top here to hold everything together so that as we pour our syrup, our molds will be gummy tight and prevent anything from leaking out. I pretty much use this stuff for everything. And I think about 2 wraps is all we're gonna need. The cleaner our mold, the cleaner our cast. Here we go. Our mold is ready for pouring. So our green's been sitting out for a few minutes here, and come check this out. If you look at the top layer, it's actually starting to cool and it forms a little bit of a skin. So any of those imperfections that were on the top before, we can literally just skim right out of there and it leaves us with crystal clear gummy. So that can be transferred to my mouth or the garbage or wherever else you want. But that's the stuff we're after right there. Those will take just a second to cool down before we can skim the top, so I thought now would be the perfect time to address a suggestion that comes out of the comments from Samith Reedy V, who says, keep melted gummy in a vacuum chamber. And by that, Samith, I assume you mean put melted gummy in the vacuum chamber, and since we have melted gummy and a vacuum chamber right here, I'm gonna put the two together for you right now. So I used a couple extra glasses and just took some samples of our gummy here. You can see it's already starting to harden up a little bit, so I'm interested to see what effect that'll do. This is a little bit colder and more like jelly, and this is a little bit more liquid. So let's put both of them inside our large glass vacuum chamber, put the lid on, and suck it up to 25 microns. All right, let's do this. Here we go. Gummy in a vacuum chamber. What does it do? The green one over here is moving just a little bit. Got some bubbles rising out of the top, but it's a lot harder syrup. If I melted these things down a little bit, we might see more bubbling. Oh, here goes purple. Did you see that? It just took off. That like came out of nowhere. It just erupted. There it goes again. Check that out. Oh, wow. You know what? I'm just gonna let it bubble over. What the heck? Why not? Look at all the bubbles coming from the bottom there. The green one's starting to bubble a little bit too. So by now I think our gummy has solidified, so let's just go ahead and open it up, take it out, take a look at it, and look at this, that is an interesting pattern. Look at that spray pattern all over the side of the glass. Very interesting. It almost looks like modern art. King of Random style. Random happens, guys. Now I'll be selling this on eBay to the highest bidder. Just joking. I'm gonna eat it instead. I love my job. All right, 2 more glasses. These are our full ones. Just came out of the microwave for another 10 seconds. Let's put them in the vacuum chamber and see how they react. Wow, that is making a royal mess. The purple is everywhere. It's completely covered the bottom of the vacuum chamber. The green's going crazy, but it's not frothing like the purple is. You see the purple is just like spewing stuff everywhere. But the green, all the bubbles are being extracted out, and that's looking really, really good. The purple, I think we like lost half of our mixture all over the place. There's foam everywhere. It's like purple bubble bath. Now that's all the green I've got, so I can't waste that, or it's gonna cause big problems later on. So I think at this point, I'm gonna turn off the vacuum chamber. What happens when we open it? Oh my goodness, did you see the way the color changed there? It was kind of like when we did slime in a vacuum chamber, all the color came back into it. Oh wow, and look down inside there, like the bottom that was all bubbles has now just turned into a gelatinous glob of volcanic gummy eruption. When I was watching these things in the vacuum chamber, it just seems like the bubbles were like cycling up and down. I didn't really see them popping too much. And if we did get them to the point of foaming and frothing, they just came right out of the glass and made a mess everywhere. Wow. Okay, that's cool. Simultaneously removing the heat and the bubbles. Oh, look at that. Okay, we had some success with that one. Okay, so this was a little bit of a different experience. Using really hot gummy syrup, we got a really nice reaction. The bubbles seem to have come out. That is crystal clear. And not only that, the surface is smooth and clear as well. So molten, like really hot gummy syrup in a vacuum chamber is great. And the cool thing is, it pulled out some of the heat as well, so this is cooled down in the process. Brilliant idea. Let's pour it in. Here's what I'm thinking. Let's pour the green gummy in first and rotate the mold around in all different directions to coat the surface of the mold with green gummy. After the green has solidified, we can pour the purple gummy in. When the whole thing sets, hopefully we'll get some kind of eerie greenish purple gummy zombie brain. It'll look awesome and taste even better. All the gummies solidified to the surface. It's like silicone, but you can eat it. This is the best part. So that's pretty much it, guys. Our gummy brains are now completely poured, and we've got gummy green and gummy purple combining to make some kind of awesomeness, I hope. How do you think our zombie brains are gonna turn out? We're gonna find out in the next video because these things need to sit in the fridge for 24 hours in order to firm up properly. But until then, thanks for joining me for this project today, guys. It was cool hanging out with you. I'll be looking for you in the next video. Talk to you then. Man, my gloves are so sticky. I think I'm just gonna take them off.